Hey YouTube, we're gonna hop right into the video. We got a lot going on today. We only have about 12 orders to pull, but let's go ahead and do that right now.
All right, we're gonna start the video off strong with a Minka Air sale.
This is the Minka Air ceiling fan remote. You guys know a lot about these already. It cost me $1.37 and it sold for full asking price of $24.99 with free shipping. For those of you who do not know, I bought these at the Habitat for Humanity Restore. There was a huge bin of them. This is my second time buying these products and reselling them. I've already made all my money back. I've made about like $400 in profit. But yeah, these things are killer on eBay and they make me a ton of money.
As you guys can see, this is what we have left. We have the receivers right there, the remotes, and this is actually my first remote sale. So yeah, pretty cool. All right, guys, we are back inside and we have a toy sale. I believe it is in here. If I'm not mistaken. Maybe this one right here.
All right, so this is a lot of Bakugan that I sourced off of Mercari. It probably cost me around $5 and it sold for $29.99 and the buyer paid for shipping. One of my favorite toys to resell right here, Bakugan, and Mercari is a really awesome place to source for toys.
And if you guys are hearing any noise, just please forgive me. My cat's in my room right now. I normally kick her out, but she wants to be in here. And she's making a ton of noise. So just forgive her. Oh. She's hitting my microphone right now.
Oh.
Okay, we got another Minka Air sale, and it's gonna be yet another remote. Lana, can you be quiet?
So again, this only cost me $1.37, but this one I took a best offer of $20 with free shipping. The person that bought this sent me a message and said that a week ago he bought the receiver, but the remote was a little off, so he wanted to buy this remote. Asked for a deal and I gave him one, cause why not, and yeah.
All right, we have a sale all the way up here. It is this toy.
I honestly cannot remember where I got this from. I wanna say I got it from a Goodwill in like a big toy bag. Probably cost me $25.50 and I had it listed for $7.99 and I took a best offer of $5. Only problem is I did not realize that I had free shipping on this thing, so I'm literally gonna make $0. Yeah, I just checked. I'm literally making 41 cents. So kinda sucks, but I mean, it's whatever. You make mistakes sometimes, just gotta learn from them and don't do that again. And just make sure that you check if you have free shipping or not. It makes a big difference when you're making these small sales. All right, I'm in the garage right now because we actually have like 5 orders to pull from here. They're all sporting goods, they're all really big. And yeah, let me show you guys what we sold.
Okay, so I guess I lied because there's one thing that's not a sporting good thing, but it is this Snoopy mug. It's a pretty cool one. There's like water in between. I don't know if you guys can see, but there's water that you put, like you freeze it and then it keeps your drink cold. I don't know, it's old.
I bought this at the Goodwill for $1.99 and it sold for $12.99 with free shipping. Not gonna make much money off of it, but I'm just glad I'm getting rid of it.
All right, so this is our first sale. It's gonna be a tennis racket that we actually just recently sourced about a week ago. It sold very fast.
I bought this for $4.99. I had it listed for $29.99 plus shipping, but I took a best offer of $21. The reason being for that is when I bought this, I thought it was an adult racket, but it was my mistake. It's actually a youth racket, so it was never worth $30 to begin with, so I'll gladly take $21 for this.
And we actually sold another tennis racket right here. This one we sourced in the summer of last year, so it's been here for a while, but it finally sold.
I bought this one at a garage sale last summer for $5 and I had it listed for $80, but I took a best offer of $70 and the buyer paid for shipping. It was a huge sale. It was a really lucky pickup. I honestly didn't even search it up when I was at the garage sale. I just bought it since it was so cheap and I kind of know a thing or two about tennis rackets, but I wasn't sure. Anyways, we got lucky. It was worth a lot and yeah, we made the sale.
Then we have this golf club. You guys know how much I love shipping out golf clubs. But this one right here,
I bought a ton of golf clubs at, I think it was Savers. So that one only cost me $1.07 and it sold for $20 plus shipping.
Yeah, sometimes at Savers you can find just like golf bags full of them. I mean, this one was for $8.99. I don't know if that's how much I bet on it, but I got like a ton of clubs in there. And like anytime I buy them, I'm always buying them like in a large quantity because I don't know. Their stores like to get rid of them. They kind of just sit there for a while, except for Goodwill. Goodwill loves to list their golf clubs and singles, and that's why they all just sit there forever.
Yeah, Goodwill, I'm throwing shade. Why do you guys list them in singles? You're never gonna sell those, okay? Just saying.
And then this last sale is this set of 7 tailor-made irons. I bought this at a garage sale for $14, and it sold for a whopping $80.50, and the buyer paid for shipping.
Yeah, that was a really good sale. I mean, it's a whole iron set, so it's gonna do well. And it's also tailor-made, so it's a good brand to resell. Sporting goods is a love-hate relationship for me. I love reselling them because there is such a large quantity of them in garage sales, thrift stores. Everybody's always trying to get rid of their old stuff. Not to mention that you can get them for fairly cheap as well. The only reason I hate them so much is because they are an absolute pain in the butt to ship out. Especially this iron set right here. I'm gonna have to Frankenbox it. It's gonna cost a lot of money. I'm hoping I can save some money on pirate ship, but we'll see. But just a little advice for you guys. With golf clubs, you wanna be looking for TaylorMade, Titleist, Cobra, and Ping. That's just what I've sourced and what I've had luck in. And for tennis rackets, I'm always just looking for Wilson. The Hyper series does really well for me. Babolat, however you pronounce it, that's another really good one to sell. But yeah, just keep your eyes on sporting goods when you're at garage sales and thrift stores, garage sales especially. You might find a good deal on a bunch of things, but just keep in mind that they are going to be a bit of a pain to ship out. All right, it's getting really hot here, so let's go back inside to where I have air conditioning and let's finish up the video.
Guys will never believe what we sold. Another Minka Air product. This time it's going to be the receiver.
So this is the receiver that goes with the remote. As you guys already know, it cost me $1.37. I have these listed for $34.99, but for this one, I took a best offer of $30.
All right, we got a Micro Machines sale. Another toy that I really like to source and resell here on eBay. This is gonna be right here. I think this is it.
But yeah, like I said, this is another toy that I really like to source on Mercari, Bakugan, and Micro Machines. Those are my favorite right there. This came from my most recent Mercari buy that most of you guys should know about. I've already made all my money back on that lot. This probably cost me around $4. I had it listed for $29.99, and I took a best offer of $23 plus shipping.
All right, and we're actually on to our last item. It is going to be a set of 2 hats, a tan and a blue one.
These hats cost me 23 cents each, so 46 cents, and it sold for full asking price of $24.99 with free shipping. All of you guys should know what these are, but for those of you who don't, I purchased 1,700 hats for $400 back in October of 2019. They only cost me 23 cents each, and I've been selling them pretty steadily for the last couple months now. I've already made all my money back and about $2,000 in profit, and I still have over 1,200 hats left. I have these listed in singles, doubles, and fours, and then I have the tan and the blue hats, and they sell pretty consistently. They don't bring in too much profit, but the fact that they only cost me 23 cents, it's a really good return. It's basically free money at this point.
And those types of things are just my favorite things to resell. When you have a large quantity of an item where you can just make one listing or two, and just constantly keep pulling orders for it. Same reason why I love these so much. And these two are a really good example of what I like. They cost me close to nothing, both of these, and they both bring in a really good return. I'm starting to kind of like these ones a little bit more just because the return is much greater. There's a larger profit, but I mean, the ROI on this one can't be beat. Toys is another thing that I'm big on. Micro Machines, Bakugan, action figures, things like that. Easy to source on Mercari, easy to source at garage sales, and most vintage toys bring in a decent amount of money.
Like these, for example, we got action figures, WWE figures.
And I'm also really big on sports cards for any of you who are new here. And if you're into sports cards as well, I recommend that you follow me on my TikTok. I'll have it in the description below. I post a lot of content over there. I don't know if I want to start making sports card content here on YouTube because I don't know how you guys will feel about that. But I guess I'm asking you guys right now.
If I made sports card content on here, which I would love to do to push more content out here on YouTube and to make more videos, what would you guys watch? Let me know in the comment section.
All right, we got everything pulled. Now it's just time to pack everything. We're gonna go ahead and pack these real quick, bust that out, and then we'll see if we can save some money on these guys. All right, guys, I am sorry for the bad lighting, but we just finished packing everything and I thought I'd go over the numbers with you guys. We sold a total of 12 items. Everything cost us $42.33, and we made a net profit of $265.90.
Right now, I'm gonna head to the post office, but that is all I have time for, unfortunately. But what I will do is tomorrow, I'll hit up a bunch of thrift stores. I'll hit up like 3 or 4. I'll record that, and then I'll just add that to the end of this video. So yeah, I will pick this up tomorrow, and for you guys, it will only be 1 second.
All right, guys, I'm here at the Goodwill, and I forgot my GoPro, of course, so. Recording on the phone. Don't know how the audio is gonna sound. Don't know how the video is gonna turn out.
here we go. All right, just real quick to see if there's any more remotes in here. Probably not. Well, that sucks. All right, well, I guess that's all we got today. I swear you guys are bad luck. Anytime I go without you guys, I get way more things. But we got this cool Nerf gun. It's like a automatic one. I don't really know how to describe it, but I gotta test it out and make sure it all works fine. But this should get me like $15 or $20 plus shipping. I only paid $1.50 for it. It was half off today. So, not a bad find. I definitely wish I would have found more stuff though. But yeah, I'm gonna go ahead and end it right here, I guess. If you enjoyed today's video, please leave a like. If you have any questions or feedback, leave me a comment down below. And to make me super, super happy, please hit that subscribe button. We just hit 100 subscribers. I'm really stoked about that. So thank you guys so much. Let's go ahead and aim for 200 now. Also, let me know in the comment section, like I said earlier, if you want to see more sports card content on here, I'd be more than happy to make some. Just let me know if you'd be interested in that. And yeah, I will see you guys next week. Doubted I would have when I flipped it in a double. Doubted I would have when I flipped it in a double.